Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 17th of 2020, well, it is titled The Windmill and the Star Trails. So what do we see here? Well, in the foreground, we see a windmill, and it is actually blocking a little bit. It's actually centered, so designed so that it will block the star Polaris and the North Celestial Pole, which are kind of hidden behind the central portion of the windmill there. Now, this Polaris is very close to the North Celestial Pole, which is the central point in the northern sky, and everything will seem to revolve around that. And we can see the stars that will then make their trails as they move through the sky here in an image combined of a number of different images, actually 39 images combined together, each a little about half a minute long to show those star trails. So we're looking over here over the course of number of minutes as to how much the stars moved. Now, as we know, the stars really are not moving. It is the Earth doing the moving. The Earth is rotating from west to east, which makes everything appear to rise in the east, which is off on the right-hand side of the image here, and set in the west over on the left-hand side of the image. So if we could watch them over a longer period of time, they would all make great circles around the celestial pole over the course of a day. Now, in this case, the final image has actually been highlighted so you can see the positions of the stars themselves. So you see this trail, and then the very last image, you'll see the actual star itself there, highlighting it, allowing you to kind of see each of these and give them the star as the head with a little trail heading off behind it. Now, a couple of other things that we can see in this image, we can see our Milky Way, and the Milky Way kind of centered in the image here is our own galaxy as we see it from within. So we can see sort of the diffuse coloring of the Milky Way there. A lot of blue and pink. The blue, of course, are bright hot stars that have formed. Hot stars give off very prominently in the blue part of the spectrum and even into the ultraviolet. The pink color is the glow of hydrogen gas, which is also associated with those stars because it is energized by the ultraviolet radiation that these hot stars produce. And those are all big signs of star formation in a spiral galaxy. Now, that's not the only galaxy we see in this image. A little bit to the right of it, we can see the Andromeda Galaxy. The Andromeda Galaxy, similar in size to our Milky Way, except that it is about 2.5 million light years away. So much more distant is going to make it appear much smaller in the sky. And here we can see it in this image as well, very close to our own Milky Way. So that was our picture of the day for April the 17th of 2020. It was titled The Windmill and the Star Trails. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.